Hi, Steve Wallace, Cheshire Timber Construction. Here we are in Poynton, removing this conservatory roof and replacing it. We're going to first of all take all the aluminium sections off of the glass out. Okay, so now we've got the aluminium sections off and all the glass out, we're fixing the wall plate. On this particular conservatory, because of the profile of the aluminium, we've had to machine the wall plate to fit over the profile. And on this particular conservatory, it was a very shallow pitch on the roof, so we're going to make that different and give it a steeper pitch. We do that for two reasons. Firstly, because it gives more feeling of space on the inside, and secondly, because having a greater fall for the water just keeps the roof cleaner, stops it getting covered in moss and collecting leaves. So we're going to fit the final section of wall plate into position and screw down into the aluminium sections with 5-inch screws. Okay, so now we've got all the rafters on, we're putting the hips and the jacks in now. This is a five-sided conservatory, and you will need a set of decent set of tables and a decent roofing square to work out the cuts for this one. We've extended the rear wall higher so we can get the steeper pitch. We're just going to board it and plywood it now. Okay, so once we plywooded the hole outside of the roof, we then felt it. Okay, so now we're insulating the inside of the conservatory. We've put 3-inch insulation in between the rafters, leaving an inch air gap on the outside. Then we put a 2-inch over the hole inside of the ceiling. Then we've put battens on, which gives us another inch air gap. And then we've put reinforced sections for the light fitting, so that when the lights are on, there's something strong to fix them to. Okay, so this is it finished.